Hi y'all, it's Curious Raven. I just want to tell y'all that I'm sorry that I have not released any other videos this week. I have had some in-laws visiting, and also I actually had someone that's really close to me at work who has passed away. Today is Thursday. I'm actually trying to record this a day before because on Friday I have his funeral to go to. I've been kind of sad. But I'm so happy for the people that are subscribed and the listeners that do listen but are not subscribed. So I think you should go and hit the subscribe button and the bell icon. My goal is to do what I love and also to try to make a living out of it. One thing y'all don't know about me is that my health would not allow me to pursue my career in law enforcement. And now I am a stay-at-home mom that takes care of her kids and husband. Like I said, I do want to try to y'all to know me. Eventually, I do want to do a live stream. I'm just actually kind of nervous. I don't see myself that interesting, so it would be a really big step for me. But soon, I do want to do a live stream. I'm kind of waiting until I have more followers. Today, we are talking about William Tyrrell, a 3-year-old little boy from New South Wales, Australia. When I actually first heard this story, it was a case of he was missing, that he just vanished in thin air. And first, to be honest, I was thinking, oh gosh, how is that possible? Did aliens come and get him? It's just, you'll understand. It was September 12th of 2014, and his family, actually, his mom and dad and him, I do think he had a sibling that was young like he was, I think 4. Well, they all decided to pack up the car and drive about 4 hours to the grandma's house. The grandma lived in more of a rural area with a lot of nice big spaces, a really big nice backyard, very beautiful. It was more like in the country, unlike them, that they lived in a city. They wanted to go and spend some time with grandma and, you know, let the kids run around and play. And the mother says that on that day, they were outside enjoying the weather. It was very beautiful. And her son that was 3, he wanted to dress up like Spider-Man, you know, play superhero. And they went outside. On the back porch area, kind of like a patio area, her and her mother sat as they watched the kids run around, and the dad had to leave and go somewhere for a couple hours or something for business. He had some type of errand to run. She said that William always liked to play like he was a tiger or a dinosaur, and he always made these little roar sounds. He was playing and acting like a creature, run around the backyard and make these little cute little roar sounds, and she was right there. She could see him. And all of a sudden, she said that he was running and he was still making the sounds, and he kind of went around a corner of the house. And she still heard him. After she couldn't see him no more, she heard him make a roar sound, like he was still playing. So she thought he was okay. Not even a few minutes later, she called out to him, said, "Hey, where'd you go?" No answer. Then she said, "Hey, William, do you see Daddy's car?" So she thought maybe he went down to the driveway, because that was like something that they did. They had like a little cute thing they do when his dad comes home, that they'll stand at the end of the driveway and wave him in, you know. And so she thought that's what he was doing. And she called him again. "William, did you go down to the end of the driveway? Hello," you know. And as she was getting up and walking around the corner, he was gone. And she said it wasn't even, not even a minute, really. A minute or two. He couldn't have gone far, right? That actually happened to me with my son before. And I was freaking out. But, you know, he's fine. We found him. But it was kind of the same thing, and he had only been gone for, like, not even 4 minutes. They can't really go that far. They got little short legs and, you know, 3. So, he was gone. thin air. She looked around. She went and she said she went around the house like 10 times calling his name and saying it's not funny. He needs to come out, not to scare her. She went to the neighbor's house to make sure he didn't go over there. She said the neighbor came out and helped her. Some of the neighbors in the neighborhood. She looked everywhere. And by that time, like 30 minutes went by that when he'd gone missing and when they stopped looking and actually called the police. By that time, William's dad did get home and they were distraught. She was beside herself. Her husband was so distraught. He said that, you know, William called him his best friend and it's very heartbreaking. They called the police. Within not even an hour, there were, I think they said like 400 police looking. There were some that was even in different counties that came to help look. And then also people, you know, normal people came to volunteer to help look for him. And they went 4 miles out of the search area thinking, okay, well maybe for some weird reason, you know, it happens all the time that they find him outside of the search area. They searched for a week and they could not find him. There was no trace of him. There was a couple leads, but not really. The cops literally said, go back home. Go back home, and we will do everything that we can. We are not going to stop. They got a lot of tips from the tip line, but nothing really stuck. Every day, you know, every time the phone would ring, they thought maybe it was the break that they needed to find little William. His mother describes him as a very funny and unique, spunky, I guess is what you would say, type of kid. He was very lively and loved to play and laugh. And in the interview, his mother was holding a little doll. She was so upset because that was the little doll that he would sleep with. The only thing that could help him sleep is him cuddling with it. And she was just so upset that her son was probably scared and alone and didn't have his little protective doll. You know, like some people do stuffed animals, some people do blankets. This poor little boy, they had no idea. They have no idea. They had 4 or 5 people of interest. The lead investigator said that they actually went through and interviewed over 1,000 people. They tried everything. And there were no answers. And remember, this happened in 2014. So this little boy has been missing for 6 years. The lead investigator went ahead and told the interviewer that there was no family ties to it. That they exonerated the family right away. Not sure how they did, but, you know, police business. They did. And to be honest, this is my opinion, but when the mother and father were on there doing the interview, you could tell that they had nothing to do with it. That interview was a year after he went missing, and they were so broken, like any parent should be. They never lost faith or hope that their little boy would be found one day. And what I mean by that is sometimes it's just, even though you know that your loved one has passed away, and you know that it's a big chance that they will not be found alive, you still get to bring that baby home, to be with family, and for the family to have a peace of mind that they know what happened to him. Well, there are new circumstances that came up. They actually came up in 2020, this year, about this case. This woman, her name was Amy, and she was babysitting these two boys. And the boy's last name was Abbott. One was named Jeffrey, but I don't remember the other boy's name, to be honest. She said that they were singing the William Tyrrell Come Back Home song. And then she overheard them talking about that they knew what really happened to him. So she busted in, I guess, and said, hey, what are y'all talking about? What do you know? And they were scared to tell her. Scared to death, because the person that the boys knew that did it said that if they told anyone that he would snap their mother's neck. And these boys were only like, I would say like 13, 14 or so, not even that old. So yeah, think about it. When this went down, They had to have been like 6, maybe 7, so they're really little too. I'm thinking it was a family member because the person that they said that hurt this little boy was Frank Abbott. The thing about Frank Abbott, is that he was actually one of the people interviewed by the lead investigators in 2014 on the missing boy. Abbott has a bad background. In the 1990s, he was acquitted of the murder of a teenage girl in Sydney. So, really, you know. Well, Amy, the babysitter of these two young boys, the Abbott boys, actually testified in their behalf because the boys were too scared. She said and explained to the courts that the older boy, Jeffrey, told her that Frank Abbott killed little William and stuffed his body in a suitcase. Now, since these are such a recent findings, I'm guessing it's an ongoing investigation. So I can't really tell you any more about it, but I will tell you that I will make sure I will follow this case for you guys, and if any more information comes up that this lunatic a-hole got found guilty and sentenced to prison or death, or he should be sentenced to death. I meant, hello, he killed another kid. He's just getting away with it. I'll let you know. I will add it to another murder mystery or murder, true crime murder video. Or if it's so much information, I'll do a whole video about it. But they have, till this day, they have not found his body. He's still missing. This is just the words of young boys. So they're still investigating it. It's ongoing. I just hope they really get this psychopath. I'm sorry, if someone did that to my child, I would be going to prison for a long time. I would make sure. I would make sure that they went through extreme pain and agony. That's all I can say. This coming up week, I will also put out more videos, not just one. I'm sorry, y'all. It's just this week was so busy. And to little William, I am so sorry, little boy, little baby. I just hope that, no. I know you're in heaven and you are in a better place. And I want to do prayers to his family too, to keep faith and keep going. Like they said in an interview, life does go on, with you or not. I hope y'all have a wonderful evening. Remember, like and subscribe to my channel. I will see y'all again Friday. Remember, it's scary out there.